Hello, welcome to the Speakeasy. I'm your barkeeper, Jeff Belanger. Don't worry, there's never a cover charge and we don't card anybody. This is the place where it's totally okay to drink alone, together. So tonight is something I'm calling a free-for-all Friday. It's a party. That's the point. We're going to try to do this every Friday night, and it's kind of crowded here in the Speakeasy. I'd like to keep this going because I know for a lot of us, it feels like Blur's Day, right? They're all just sort of blending together. But damn it, it is Friday. It is the weekend. Even if you're not working right now, even if you feel like your life's totally in a rut, I think it's okay to blow off a little steam with us because that's what we're doing. That's why we're here. Now, there's a few people to introduce tonight, including our very first musical guest. Oh, how exciting is that? So let's get to it. First, from the Twin Cities of Minnesota, from the Holzer Files on the Travel Channel, from Darkness Radio, and where you really know him is from previous speakeasies, please welcome my good buddy, Dave Schrader.
Oh, you're here.
Oh, look at you're here. Hey, and if you folks are watching, share this right now because other people need to be here in the speakeasy with us. So please get to it. Dave, what are you drinking tonight?
Jeff? I wanted to step up my game. Plus, you know how I like to really find interesting things, right?
Yes.
So I decided, since we've got an adventurer joining us again tonight.
We do?
I'd free the Kraken.
Oh! Kraken
black rum.
Oh, nice.
You like that? Now, it's also, of course, mixed with the only drink that you and I like, generic cola.
Generic cola is the best.
Here's my favorite part of this package. When I bought the bottle, they gave me my very own flask, and it says Kraken. So now when I go to famous places with you, Jeff, you and I can walk around and ask people to fill my Kraken.
Yes, you will fill the Kraken. That's wonderful. That's right. Now, Dave, listen, I know you like music. I know you love you some Bruce Springsteen. I know you love you some Prince. But, Dave, is there another band that you love that's right up there with all the biggies? I mean, a band maybe you've actually hung out with?
I have the Monkees, but they weren't available. Slamabama's available. They're my most favorite band named Slamabama ever.
Dave, have I got news for you. Live what? From Birmingham, Alabama, we've got Jay and Rosanna. Look at, there they are.
What?
In the bathroom.
Can I tell you that before we went live, when we were backstage just now, I said the Monkees. And then I knew it was coming.
And there it is. Guys, what are you drinking tonight?
I've got me a little Starbucks Pike's Peak.
Ooh.
And I have some Coke Zero Cherry, actually. So.
Oh, fancy.
Funny story, we're not drinking tonight. That's kind of weird, but it's okay.
We've been, I don't know.
We're drinking.
All right.
We're still trying to drive ourselves to drink. We have. Yeah. It's a test of a will, and we'll let you know how long it lasts.
Fair enough. Folks, send your comments in too. We'll try to get to all of them. But first, we got someone else to introduce. We've got everybody represented. We got middle of the country with Minnesota. I'm in New England, the Boston area. We got Alabama down south. I think we need someone from the West Coast. So from Los Angeles, you remember from Destination Truth, from Chasing UFOs. She's a producer, an adventurer, and she's our good buddy, Erin Ryder.
Hey, darling.
What are you drinking, Erin?
Welcome to my kitchen. I'm having a red stripe tonight. Thank you for asking, Jeff.
Oh, Jamaica, man. And I've got some Baxter Brewing right here, doing a little bit of the Stowaway IPA. Cheers to all of you. Thank you for joining us.
Cheers.
Well done. This is like school on Saturday. Lots of class. Anyway, I'd like to kind of go around the horn. Ryder, let's start with you. How are you faring in this here quarantine situation?
You know, you take it day by day, sometimes hour by hour, have some good days, some bad days. Lately I've been volunteering a lot, which has been really exciting to be able to give back during this time.
What are you doing to volunteer? But how do you volunteer remotely? What are you doing?
We've been delivering donations to hospitals. We've been getting them coffees and food and treats, just little things to show them how appreciative we are of all the work they're doing on the front lines.
Oh, very awesome. Love that. Good stuff. Okay, what about you, Jay and Rosanna? What are you guys up to? How are you holding this down?
Well, we've been riding a lot, which has been cool. It's kind of, you know, we're always on the road. And so it's been kind of cool to actually not be on the road for a short time, even though it's not for the best reason. We've been able to be a little more creative than normal. And We even got a new single finished, which is coming out on Cinco de Mayo. So we're still working hard.
We are going to reveal the title of the single later. Not now. Not now. We're going to wait. We're going to tease it all the way to the end. You guys are going to play some songs for us. So funny story, the last time all of us were together was in a place called Monoman, Minnesota. Do we all remember that?
Shooting Star Casino.
Look at that. There we are. Ryder's in there somewhere. And look at them all. You guys, look at you guys. Oh, there's Dave Schrader.
Oh, there he is.
Look at this with Grant Wilson.
Oh, I'm a blur. I'm a ghost in the background on that one.
Yeah, look at there's a little Ryder there. And then we got, of course, that with the Bama boys.
Oh,
nice.
Deep South and no charge there for that photo bomb. That was a good time. We so the thing is when you know the band's on stage and they're great and we're all rocking and we're all in the bar doing our thing, but then we blurred the lines. You guys came out and hung out with us.
We did. And then you came up on stage with us a couple of times.
Ah, come on. I did not. Oh, wait. There's a picture.
Yes.
Just a picture. You should have checked my Facebook. I've got the entire video of you up there singing.
I think that was a screen cap of your video, actually.
That was good times. That was with Dustin Perry, too. I believe we did The Gambler.
We did The Gambler. And the first time you came up, do you remember what you did the first time?
Probably Blister in the Sun. I only know two songs.
Our drummer had never played it, so I had to play drums on that.
You played
guitar.
I did. And we got through that. That was epic. That was just an epic night. So
I remember parts of that. That was when I was drinking.
That was not a Code Zero and Coffee Night.
All right. Well, listen, why don't you guys, can you start us off with a song? Would you mind? Can we do that?
Yeah, we thought we'd do this one in honor of having to be quarantined.
All right.
Today.
We're going to give you guys front and center here. Here we go.
All right. Hey, I'm having a party. Want to come?
I don't think so.
Come on. It'll be lots of fun.
I think I'll stay at home.
Oh, it's gonna be really, really hot.
Starting to sound good.
I'm gonna put you on the spot.
Thinking maybe I should.
Yeah, there'll be lots of morning.
I guess I could be there. What should I wear?
I'm having a party for two.
A party for two.
And
You got a dog.
Oh, puppies.
Oh, it's a puppy.
So cute. Introduce us to the new guest, please, Erin.
This is Cowboy.
Cowboy.
Hello there, Cowboy.
Yeehaw, Cowboy.
I follow his adventures on Instagram. He gets out more than you and I ever do, Jeff. It's pretty remarkable.
I totally believe that. So we totally forgot to address why you're in the bathroom there, Jay.
Well, we've been during the lockdown, we've been doing a series of singing in the shower shows called Live from the Pink Bathroom. We're down in Birmingham. And look at that. There it is. Live from the Pink Bathroom.
It's his mom's pink bathroom.
It is in Bluff Park, Alabama. It's Mamie Eisenhower pink is what they call this
Mamie
color. And we've been doing pink bathroom shows. We've been doing great. We've been getting thousands of viewers. It's been fantastic, and now we get to be here with you.
We can't do live shows at all, and so we really miss it, and it's we have to keep connecting with our fans and our people. We miss it so much, and it's been a blast. We had the best time. It's incredible.
It's been great. We do it on our Facebook, so it's just facebook.com/slamabama if you want to follow the
Saturday.
Wednesdays at 7 and Saturdays at 9.
Awesome stuff. Yeah. So, Erin, what are you working on? Tell us something good. I know you're volunteering and making us all look bad, but like, how about projects? I mean, are you using your producer mind to think of the next great show that's going to involve, like, say, a musical group from Alabama and like a bald radio guy from Minnesota, like a New England, totally devilishly handsome guy? Like, I don't know. I'm just spitballing here.
Who told you?
Who spilled the beans? Yeah, we have a couple things in the works that are really exciting that we're out pitching. Unfortunately, COVID has slowed things down a little bit, and a few things that we were working on had to pause. So we're hoping to announce a few things soon. So I hate to be so mysterious about it all, but there are a lot of things that are under wraps and we sign NDAs. But we have a couple exciting projects that we're hoping come through maybe in the fall.
Cool. Well, that's good stuff. Erin, you also sent me some pictures, and look at, you know, like just totally freestyling there. There's Dave in the back.
This is still at the Shooting Star Casino. Yeah.
So it gets, I mean, it's adorable, right? There we are, a big old group. There's Dave. But then I wanted to show a couple that you showed, Erin. We're going to have to talk about these. There's you. There's, I don't know what Dave is thinking or looking at.
Where are your hands?
And I don't know what these folks in the back are doing or thinking, but the selfie game's on point. And then there's this one.
Why is it that Dave looks like a cardboard cutout in a lot of his photos?
So, okay, wait. I have a question. Is someone trying to make me jealous?
Wait, if you looked at the group photo, you and I have a selfie together. In the group photo, I just couldn't find the original.
Yeah, but do we look like, I mean, I don't know. Do we look like we're cozy enough like that?
Oh, that's adorable. No, we don't look that cozy.
Yeah, so I don't appreciate you trying to like come between us.
Oh, I could never get between that. Look at you.
No, you could. You'd need a crowbar to get between us, Ryder.
You know what, Jeff?
Yes.
Oh my God.
I forgot when I was sending you photos, and I'm going to send you this for a future show. Do you remember one time Roseanne and I had taken this cuddly little picture in the car, and you and Dave recreated that photo? Do you remember that?
Was that on the airplane?
Yeah, we were on an airplane.
I think it was the airplane.
And you guys text me a photo of the two of you in the exact same position that the two of us were in the airplane.
That sounds like something we would do.
I'm going to have to send you that. I'm going to have to find that. That's somewhere.
But, you know, Dave, sometimes our love affair gets awkward. You remember, Dave. You remember the baby.
Oh, yeah. He does not like to share me, even with children, Erin.
You guys look like you're wearing the same outfit.
Yeah, we are.
Whatever.
You got a problem
judging us. We would never wear the same outfit.
Ever. Mostly.
I love that.
I mean, we might coordinate, but that's different.
You know that's what? Awesome. So at the Manoman event in Minnesota, right? This big Paracon that used to take place. I had one of the most surreal moments because as the night progresses, usually we all just get a little bit more libations and everybody loosens up. And there's the main bar where Slamabama plays above the bar, and it's flipping awesome at Mustangs. Then back around the corner, there's this little kind of hidden nook bar that sucks because Slamabama can't play back there. Otherwise, they just have to stand in the little waterfall. But anyway, I'm coming back from the little bar heading to the big bar, and I see Erin Goodwin, Billy Tolley, and Jay Wasley, and they're like, "Schrader, you have to get over here quick." And I'm like, "What?" And they go, "Dude," and Erin Goodwin's like, "Dude, time travel shit's happening right now, right here." And I'm like, "What?"
Well, I remember this.
He takes me around the corner. I'm wearing a short sleeve, like eighth grade teacher shirt with buttons, right? It's checkered. I look like an eighth grade substitute teacher. I walk around the corner. There is this old man, bald, my exact same glasses, the identical shirt, but like 15 to 20 years older than me, sitting there. And we're all just kind of walking around him. And I go, "I need a picture." So he's like literally on the last slot machine. I walk over to the side and I kind of lower myself. And Erin walks by and takes a side picture of me, of the two of us. I'll have to dig it out for next time. Dude, it is trippy. It looks like you're looking at me and then 20 years into the future me, both locked in a mortal hell of old casinos and stale beer and cigarette smoke.
Well, you know what you got to look forward to, Dave?
Yeah. Erin Ryder dancing on the bar. That's what I get to look forward to.
I know. Is it time for shots yet, Ryder?
Sure, Jeff.
Oh, cheers.
Cheers with you.
Cheers. Yeah, Erin. You actually got Great. Thrown out. Did you actually
get thrown out? For dancing on a table during one of your songs.
So it's Slamabama's fault.
I would never blame them. I just saying they incited a little bit. I was too excited.
Yeah, well, and that's not your fault.
But if you weren't playing such amazing music, you wouldn't have felt the call of the wild to step up onto the table and begin dancing.
The bouncer that kicked me out said, "I have never 86 someone from here, and people have done a lot of bad things here." And I was like, "Well, that's got to go on the wall somewhere."
Yeah,
we're like, as the bouncer has you in a chokehold, we're all like, "She's one of the speakers. No, don't do that." Jay's getting ready to dive off stage to save you, but you know the show must go on.
It's pretty legendary. They have new staff now, but they've been warned about me.
Is your photo like in the back room?
I hope so. I hope so, because they all recognize me.
Yeah, but it's taken from this angle, so you just see her legs and butt in the picture.
God, yes. I miss you guys. I miss being somewhere. You know, Jay and I were talking earlier today, like we're all performers in our own right. Like we're all doing something. And I've come to realize, like, we'll die without an audience, right?
So true.
I will.
Yeah, I have been doing something creative. I've covered this for my wife by myself. Notice mostly in the lines everywhere.
Ooh.
That's awesome. I can brag on Rosanna. She is about, I'd say, 70% through a 2,000-piece puzzle right now.
I'm almost done. And every day today, like, I was obsessed before we started this. I'm like, I gotta finish this blue bowl ring. I gotta finish this. And so
it's important to keep goals during this time. I applaud that.
I have that.
She's killing it. I usually drop at the beginning. I would drop in for like 15 minutes, and I'd find two pieces that fit, and then I'd have like a personal celebration, and then I quit.
No
but
joke.
She has done it.
I got the 2,000 piece puzzle because I just, you know, naively thought that I was going to get some help with this puzzle.
You are. He's staying away.
I'm sorry. I'm a cheerlead.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, so he's like, great job. So now I I rarely take full credit for something. I'm going to take full credit for this when I get it done.
She should.
Ryder, have you taken up any hobbies that you said not in a million years, but yet here you are?
I'm staying at an Airbnb and I've started gardening here. The owner is going to be super happy with some of my work.
What are you planting? Does it rhyme with schmanibus?
Oh yeah, he's going to be real happy till you dig up the body.
Your camera here, you have way too much intel about what's happening around here.
I'm just taking a stab in the dark.
Oh, that's the first thing you go to is schmanibus.
don't worry, the landlord won't see it because you've only got it in the closet. Allegedly.
Oh God! So besides gardening, what are you planning besides whatever?
Schmanibus.
Oh, it's just succulent so far. It's really pretty. It's kind of a long. I'll give you guys a tour one of these days. It's really nice.
Well, that'd be great, and it's safe because we don't violate any sort of restraining order when we're remote like this.
Yeah. All the social distance in order. Yeah.
Totally good. Dave, how are you keeping your sanity? Listen, is it okay? No.
You thought I was kidding.
No, I'm not kidding.
For myself. It's my unicorn coloring book. I've been working hard, man.
Are you going to publish it?
I might.
I'd like to buy one.
It's a unicorn sloth, man. It's magical. You got to find your wins where you can find them.
Listen, we all got refrigerators somewhere, Dave. That's got a spot. You mail that to me.
It's in the, well, that one's
right here. Dave, I can go right there.
That is a big empty expanse that needs to be covered, Ryder. I'm working on one for you.
I'm looking for a unicorn sloth. It's weird that you talked about it.
Wow. Would you sign it? One of one?
Yes.
Dave, you texted me earlier today. We're going to bring it down a bit. You said you're having a tough day. I think it's important to talk about. Yeah, no, we're going there. Wow.
He's like, yeah. Cute.
Remember that bond of friendship? Broken, I see. It's broken. Where I thought it was tight, it seems broken.
Are you sure?
Well, all right, maybe not.
Oh, Chip.
Currently straight.
Because I think it's back, Dave. Tell me about a bad. No, I think we got to talk about bad days too, man. I'm having them. You go.
You are the Mr. Rogers of the drunken sect. I appreciate that.
You're among friends. Let's talk about the bad too. Go ahead.
You know, what it really comes down to is, and because I don't want to bring this party down, this is a lot of fun. There's so much information being thrown my way every day, and I wish I knew what was real and what wasn't.
Yeah.
And that's just, as a dad who has an immunocompromised daughter and an immunocompromised wife, it's a scary time to think that we're going to reopen. I don't want to seem like I'm, you know, Henny Penny hiding underneath the roof either, but it's just so terrifying because as much as people want to get back out into the living world, people are dying and people from all walks of life. And it's just, you know, you know, as parents, it's a terrifying time.
Yeah, no, for sure. And I think we're all guilty of news overdoses, whether online or on TV or whatever, like, cause I mean, all the opinions are coming at us from every angle. I totally get it. And there's days where I stay away from it and I feel great. And there's days when I can't, right. Yeah. It's like a fix. You get online and you start clicking and you're like, oh, disinfectant, wait. And then you're like, breathing masks and like you just keep clicking down the rabbit hole deeper. Oh, and then there's Ryder and she's safe now. Sorry.
Too soon, Jeff. Too soon.
I'm sorry you're having a day.
Yeah. Ryder, tell us about one of your bad days. Come on, we're all sharing.
When I'm having a bad day, I've actually just found this new class. It's a dance class. It's Ryan Hefferton. I'll literally send it to you guys. There's no way to have a bad day when this guy's doing moves like the Nancy Pelosi and the Hermes. It's just so hard to have a bad day when you're dropping it like the dirty diaper and stuff. It's like all the moves that the kids are doing in the clubs these days. It just feels good.
Really? Who knew that I've been running a club at home all these years? I've got so many dirty diaper stories. I had no clue. It was just the in dance.
It's so hip right now.
No, that's cool. And I get it. Like, I mean, you got to move physically. You got to like get your heart rate up. You have to. I mean, you'll go nuts. I mean, it's totally, I don't know. All right. Jay, Rosanna, come on, weigh in. Bad day. You're stuck in a bathroom in your mom's house in Alabama. Like,
do we need to go any further?
Never has a bad day. This guy doesn't have a bad day.
I don't really have a bad day.
He doesn't. Rosanna's
a bad day if she doesn't get another 10% of her puzzle done.
Fair.
Well, and I've made myself like once because I did start getting like, you know, unhappy. And then I had read up on a couple of things. I've been trying to make myself have little victories.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but I want to go to bat for her for a second because I want to say something. We're a small business. Slamabama is a small business, and we're doing everything that all the other small businesses have to do. And when it comes to like, the PPP and the whatever all these things are called.
Yeah, the unemployment.
Rosanna has been. She's kind of the CFO of Slamabama anyway. She always has been. But let me tell you something. I don't know. This is the time where I realize the fact that I don't know what I would do without her because she literally wakes up in the morning. I'm not kidding. She wakes up in the morning and she goes straight to all the sites. She does all the make sure she's turned everything in. I mean, this has been her like just her.
And no joke, we're still
she's
waiting.
A force to be reckoned with.
We're waiting on everything still. We're in a holding pattern on everything. So I just stalk all the sites because nothing's coming through for us. And I mean, we're fine, but I mean, it's frustrating because it's just like, nothing's coming through for us. And so kind of on that, I still don't feel like, even though I'm doing stuff like, it wasn't getting accomplished. And so I've not been a person who makes their bed every day.
And when you hear on the news, how they're always like, the smaller the business, the harder it's been, and that is very, very true. There's no doubt about that. We're a little small business, the two of us and the guys doing their thing and stuff. And the smaller the business, it seems the harder it's been. And it hasn't, fortunately we haven't had to go without. We've done really well. We've really been misers throughout this entire thing too, which has been nice. We've actually, to be honest with you, I feel like we've learned some stuff for when we come out of this because we're spenders. We like to spend some.
Now you're all resourceful.
Killing me.
I'm so sorry.
It's killing me. Okay.
I want to brag on you.
I appreciate it. Yeah. But I will stop because we don't want to hog the program. But I've never been a make my bed in first thing in the morning person, and that I had read some things to do to make sure that you feel better going through. And one of the things was like, make your bed first thing. So when you make your bed, you immediately have a feeling of accomplishment. And if you've had a bad day at the end of the day, when you go back to the bed, it's made.
That's good.
It really has helped me. And
small win. I love that.
Making beds, bowel movements, it's all plus college.
The funny thing is that I was staring at Dave while she was in, and I want to say that she said make your bed, Dave, not shit your bed.
Oh. Maybe some people have time to do both. Don't hate.
She's already in the watch as we speak.
I know. But you know what? I get it. Believe me, I'm a contractor. I've been a total contractor since 2004. I have all 1099 income from everything I do. And I'm a small business too. It's scary. And like you got into it for the music. I got into it for the writing and the stories. And suddenly you have to be a freaking like accounting wizard, which is something I never even wanted to be. But like, if you don't, you're like, you're out in the cold. So suddenly, you spend all day trying to learn stuff.
Yeah, watching videos, just trying to get as much information to
help
us.
There are some great YouTube videos out there too. Some great stuff with like certain people that are doing really, really good, like up to the minute business stuff.
I want to see y'all's like, bathroom boss lady. Like, I want to see what you're doing. I'll take some tips. I would take some Rosanna and Jay tips.
Bathroom boss lady. That's the show you need.
Okay, there it is.
There's some TV producers watching this right now, and they're just taking notes, man. They got like 8 shows already from this. So, Ryder, here's a question for you, because like one thing that's happened, we've seen it. We know Josh has got his own thing streaming, right? And so suddenly everybody's doing stuff like this because we want to feel connected. And networks are having Skype guests and StreamYard guests and so on. Do you think some of this is going to stick around after, or do you think everybody's going to flock back to TV?
No, absolutely. You'll see that the echo of this lasts for a little while. And I think it's a good thing and it's a scary thing. The good thing is because it's a new medium, it's really fun to explore and try new things and be able to stay at home, especially for people that you know aren't able to freely move around. It's a great new medium. And for other people, it's really scary because that was their livelihood and they would go out and they would talk in front of live audiences, play in front of live audiences. So I think you're going to see a combination of both. But to start, because we're going to have to be a little bit more cautious, certainly they're COVIDizing a lot of programming. So you're going to see clip shows, you're going to see shows from home, you're going to see, these types of Zoom calls, Skype interviews, that kind of thing is going to last a little bit longer. But it's not going to be a forever thing.
Yeah, no, I get it. But I think it's so, what I love is that whenever there's a void, right? Like nature abhors a vacuum and suddenly people are filling it and people are getting so creative. The meme game has been on point, right?
So good.
So good.
For the record, my kids abhor a vacuum too. They won't even touch it.
That's fair.
This is a time for humor. This is the time where we're all aligned. I don't think we've been unified like this in a really long time. I'm talking internationally unified. We all have the same bad guy and we're all aligned against it, right? We may have different ideas about what's safe and what's not, when it comes to, certain things, but ultimately this has put us all in a very similar position. And it's really fun to just joke together and wake up in the morning and just be sharing just the one laugh that gets everyone going and getting through another hour, getting through another day. I think that's been really fun.
That's why Jay and I have a new show called Two in the Pink, One with a Drink.
On that note, hey, it's number two.
Woo! Hey, listen, this is starting to feel like an episode of Brady Bunch. Hi, Jay.
Hey,
Erin.
Hi,
Erin. Hi, Dave. All right, listen. I think Slamabama should do another song because I got to reload.
Yes, please.
We're going to do a little Maine Lager here from Baxter Brewing. And I think Slamabama, are you guys ready for another song?
Sure.
We are.
All right. We're going to duck out and have a drink while you guys light it up.
All right, what were you going to say? Real quick.
Our theme is Two in the Pink and a Camera in the Sink.
That is our theme. Okay. That's actually on the t-shirts.
That's on the t-shirts.
So.
All right.
All right.
Love it.
I need one. I need one.
We're kind of quarantine theme songs tonight.
All right. You guys got
loving you isn't the right thing to do.
How can I ever change things that I feel?
If I could, baby, I'd give you my word.
If you won't take it from me,
you can go your own way. Go your own way. You can call me another lonely day. Another lonely day. You can go your own way. Go your own way. Tell me why. Everything's turning around.
Shacking up is all you wanna do.
If I could, baby, I'd give you my word.
How can I, if you won't take it from me? You can go your own way.
You can call me another.
Yay!
Oh no! Oh no, Dave!
That was experimental at the end there, little jazz.
Oh, nice.
You have no idea how uncomfortable this makes people when you go into the grocery stores.
Do they keep like 6 feet apart? 6 feet away?
They do. They do. But they're always very kind to point out the Chianti beans. Or no, fava beans.
The fava beans.
Good thing we're recording this. We'll redo that again, right?
Yeah, we'll totally edit that out.
They always good to point out where the fava beans are.
Hey-o. That was great, guys. So Wednesday nights. Wednesdays and Saturdays, you've been doing this. You've been jamming from the potty. That's amazing.
Yeah, we've had eight of them so far.
Yeah, so episode nine. We on Wednesdays we started out doing more of our original based with some covers on Wednesdays, a little shorter show, and then we do a little bit longer show on Saturdays, which is just covers and fun. And Jay does a parody song every week now.
Every Saturday.
Saturday he does a parody song. Fun. So yeah. There you go. It's Slamabama. At our Slamabama Facebook Live.
And Jay, you said that's your mom's place?
Yeah.
It is. Yes. The house I went to.
Did she ever show up?
What's that now?
Is she still around? Does she ever come?
She is. She's actually our co-host. We call her Ed McMom.
She's off to the side and we have her reading comments.
Yeah.
If we can get her to stop just talking about people she knows. She's so cute. She's like, oh, look, there's my pastor from church. I'd like to give a shout out to my neighbor.
Good to hear Jay. Mom, I'm trying to do a show.
Oh dear. Oh dear. Now Dave and I are going to join and just have some filthy things for her to say.
No, we have fun. She doesn't like to get on camera. She's right off camera and she reads us the comments and stuff.
We got her to come on one time. She was like, she planned ahead of time. She got dressed up, did her hair and makeup, you know, and she was like, came, and then we had her do one turn and she walked right off.
So cute.
She's adorable. And people love her. So
they're always saying,
"Where's the toilet?" Either of you sitting on the toilet? Where is the toilet in comparison to where y'all are?
At the end of the show, we usually
look at how easily Ryder falls into the whole like y'all and yeah. She's like,
oh yeah.
The toilet's like right where I am, right? The toilet's right here.
The toilet is in front of my knee, right here.
Yeah, like right where I am.
Normally, yeah, right where you are.
Right.
Normally we're back in the shower, but since we wanted to chat and see you, we came out.
Because this is a classy show, they took me to the front of the stage.
Can you do one episode in a bubble bath?
Dude, we can do that. The standard, Ryder, the standards are so low.
Actually, in
the great. Guitar that way though.
I can just sit on the
would
toilet.
Be with that attitude.
Now let me in the bubble bath. He's on the toilet. We'll just do a different angle. That's a good idea.
Dude, listen, we could do this all from the bath. So
next time we have
a whole bathroom show.
Absolutely.
No, I think it's great. I think it's absolutely brilliant.
Oh, we could turn it into like a barbershop quintet.
You don't want me to harmonize right now. You don't want that.
Come on. How many shots are you at?
Sit there and go.
Baritone.
We could test and see if there's any delay. If there's no delay in this, then it's a harmony waiting to happen.
You know, Erin, you could do it.
It's going to wait a long time to happen.
Yeah. Harmony that's going to need to wait. It can still wait.
It'd be beautiful.
Absolutely.
Okay, so how many shots are you in, Ryder?
That was two, third seat up. You tell me when.
Yeah, go.
Okay.
Cheers. Whoa, Jay, slow down. You're gonna get. You're not gonna sleep tonight with all those jitters.
He's got a good mixed drink. It's the cherry and the Coke.
It is both. Yeah.
So, Ryder, where's that fancy tequila from?
That is George Clooney, the Casamigos.
Good stuff.
Just that's dropping right. Names, huh?
Oh, yeah, him and I go back.
Yeah, I hear you.
No, Jeff, she said George Clooney. Clooney. Oh. She can't afford Clooney stuff.
Right, no.
Sorry, I'm just slurring already.
Oh, good.
I'm glad finally somebody's keeping up with drinking, because so far I'm three episodes into this, and I'm the only one that goes out.
Hold on. How often have you been filling that Kraken?
Not often enough. That's an official chip coffee. Thumbs down.
Oh, it got the thumbs down.
We're all just regular people. Yeah, Michael. except Dave.
I'm very irregular.
That's true. Every morning I get a text from him like, nope, not today. It's just.
That's why Rosanna likes making beds. I like making poop. It all, you know, take the win where you can get it.
We have to all have our say. It's okay.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm noticing more and more. Why is it that my goatee is white and then coming into a brown hue? Why is it that I've got just one patch is hanging on for dear life? I'm not going white!
I have no idea why. I couldn't even get it.
Jeff, I need you to make it so we can actually cut to Chip live doing that.
Oh, I don't know how fast I can make that happen. Chip, are you watching? Yeah, Dave, press the call.
He knew this was coming.
Yeah.
I feel like there's a horn you blow, like it's the conch shell or something. No?
Sometimes you serve it up, and I'm just going to let the ball go right by, Jeff. That's all I got to say.
Wait, Jeff, do you stand during this? You don't actually sit?
Yeah. Because, wow. Like, if you saw how janky this whole setup was, you'd be so impressed. I got, like, a stepladder and, like, a flashlight hanging from the ceiling.
And his daughter's behind there trembling, trying to hold the sheet up for him.
Please take us behind the scenes one day. I just want one behind the scenes.
Oh, my God. But what's great is, like, it's so funny because when this went down, I'm looking around the house and I'm like, wait, I got like, spare parts. I could build a car, you know? I'm like, I got a laptop and I got a microphone and I got a stepladder and this, like, light thing. And so
where did the stepladder go?
Because the stepladder is just the right height for my laptop. I'm kind of tall.
Oh, it becomes a stand-up desk. I see.
Yeah.
I was noticing your movement and I was like, he's not in a chair. He's so fluid right now.
I love that.
I need to stand. I'm a pro. Like, you get your energy up. You guys are all just, you know, hey, when you guys are on stage,
right, sit. I'll just stand the rest of the time.
He's wearing pants.
Oh no, I revealed everything.
Yeah. I thought we weren't gonna do that. I thought it was no pants.
And shoes.
Wow.
I can't reach you there.
Oh God, Jeff's gonna do the splits.
No.
Are you slippers?
I do have slippers on. Wait.
He's going to do the splits. Oh, God, this is when the whole thing crashes.
Oh, Kip. Sorry. I'm in my basement. I'm telling you. Look, wait.
I thought you were in the woods at night.
Yeah, you were in the whole.
I really thought you were outside.
I really thought you were.
See, Jeff, now I feel good because I'm sitting in the only corner of the house that's clean.
What's to the other side, Dave?
That's my bathroom. My
I know, show us.
In case I want to go EVP after the show.
He's here all night, folks.
Wait, we just heard mom laughing in the next room.
Is she watching?
So cute.
I heard her laughing.
Ed McMahon?
Ed McMahon.
It must have been when you moved your camera.
Wait, so the funny thing is, my mom wants to be on. Like, she's like, when should I plan on being on the Speakeasy? And I'm like, oh, it's the schedule's so full, Mom. I don't even. Yeah.
I think what really was the most shocking, I think what you were referring to just now, because Rosanna's like, what is it? Just reminds me. I think you pulled like a Truman Show just now. Like I feel like you ever seen the movie The Truman Show?
Oh, yeah.
You know, everything's like the fake walls and the fake sky and everything, and all of a sudden you pull it away, and it felt like the Truman Show to me. Like, it was like, oh no,
well, it's
not real.
Your background really reminds me of that first like lost footage.
Oh, the
film.
The
Blair Witch.
Blair Witch.
You got your Blair.
Gilligan's
Witch.
Island.
Hold on, I'll give you a little Blair Witch right now.
Yeah. Well, it's not global for me, Ryder.
I'm so
can you do the snot? Oh,
yeah, I'm sorry. That was my impersonation of the Blair Witch.
And this year's Academy Award goes to Erin Ryder.
That was dead on.
You should do another shot because I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen after that.
Okay.
You know, we're right here now.
We're down here with David.
You guys are so much closer all of a sudden.
Dave, we just went into 3D. So you know what's funny? Someone's going to pause that, Ryder, when, because this is going to be out there for, you know, ever. And someone's going to pause that and, like, make a T-shirt.
Oh, by someone, you mean these two guys?
Sorry. That is from the source. That is source right there.
That's good.
That's kind of, you want to know how close we are to the toilet?
I thought maybe you were reading the ticker tape from Wall Street.
How are your stocks doing?
I don't mean to show up.
Buy, buy, sell, sell.
Just sell. Sell. Sell it all.
Well, ain't that just Charmin?
Dave, how many props do you have with you? David wants to know.
I got nothing. I got my...
You have nothing.
I got my mask.
You had a flask. You got the 3D glasses.
I got my, well, it makes the
well, I own that.
No, I'll better. Be back.
I don't that up anymore. I own that.
We have props, but they're all bathroom items.
I don't know where they are now.
Wait, my parents are watching right now. Can I give a shout out to Chris and Gail?
No. Of course you can.
Can I give a shout out to Crystal Gail?
Because I'm already in my basement, right? Whatever.
Oh, God. What's he got? His Halloween box? Oh, good.
Oh, that's nice.
Inbred Bigfoot this week on Expedition Unknown.
Do I sound really clear?
Yeah, perfectly. You sound like I normally hear you.
Rosanna's gone.
Damn it, traitor.
Oh, she's gone.
Oh.
She's going to the other
bathroom. It's just me in the poopery now.
Oh. That's another show, me in the poopery.
That's because you're supposed to spray it first, Jay.
Jay, did this show just end your relationship?
That was fast.
I just saw what his mom, you know, all the Facebook stuff, that all the things they try to sell you on Facebook.
The T-shirts.
She's a sucker for that stuff. And so she got me this.
Wait, hold it up.
Oh, oh that's yeah. Good.
Social distancing champion.
That's good.
Yep. There you go.
T-shirt. I almost wore it, but I didn't.
That would
be fancy.
Oh, Ryder, there's a question for you.
Bigfoot was walking like an Egyptian.
Okay, Ryder, what are you binging besides Tiger King and praying for a season two?
Devs? On FX.
Okay, rock on.
I love Nick Offerman. I don't love the Russian accents, but I'm on FX and I'm eating Devs. I don't love it. I want to love it. I'm waiting for it to come out. I'm sticking with it.
All right, Jay and Rosanna, Tiger King, too close to home.
You know, never mind. Our,
what? They're in Alabama. What?
I know.
No, I like that. I like. Actually,
come on.
We actually did do the Tiger King song. We did
here,
Kitty, Kitty on one of our pink.
We
did
that.
Just 30
seconds.
Go.
Oh man, I can't remember how that dang song.
Come on.
We did it in like episode 2, which has been like 3 weeks ago.
I don't like to get fancy, but would this help? Does that jog the old memory, Jay?
I have this riches. I'm okay.
Yeah. He's way richer than that.
Yeah. Dude, you know what the street value that is?
After Life 2 started today, by the way. See if you're one of great TV shows. I don't know if you guys see Afterlife.
Again, sorry.
Ricky Gervais, Afterlife.
Oh yeah.
Afterlife 2 starts today. So ooh. That is a great show.
It's all a right. Great show. So. And funny thing, Slamabama, like when we first met you guys, I was like, oh, they're the band, right? But like you guys are actually way into paranormal. Like
Yeah,
watching the shows and everything.
She really is.
It's my thing. It's been my thing. I lived in 200 houses, you know, growing up. And so I believe in it all. Well, pretty much all of it. I mean, but I'm not, you know, naively, you know, but I believe there's all kinds of stuff out there. And so I think
you knew that the minute we met you, though, because you knew half the people, you know what I mean? Like you were so tuned in when we all met. Yeah.
Well, you know what? I like to do research. So right. I just do. And so I, you know, I just got it.
Some call it stalking.
Oh, yeah.
Hold on, my mom just thought maybe Josh Gates can find Carol's husband. I'm dead.
That would be amazing. That would be so amazing.
I think that explanation better off left unsaid.
Wait a minute. That's our show. Like, Slamabama is the music, and the three of us research trying to find Carol's husband.
Oh, my gosh. Let's do that.
I'd watch the hell out of that.
Oh, we could crush that.
Dude.
We could do all the Tiger King songs. He doesn't sing anyway.
What do we call it?
Right? That's not really him?
Yeah, we know he's not really singing. Quit ruining everything.
Oh, sorry.
What? What?
What?
That's not in the show.
It's nothing.
My kids are watching Jay and Rosanna. Anything you want to talk to them about with the Santa Claus and Easter Bunny situation?
Jesus, guys.
Dude, did a better Blair Witch than I did and didn't even intend to.
You didn't.
Oh, God. Wait, right here. That's the t-shirt. It's the quad.
Did I have something up there?
Wait. Okay, Jay, Rosanna, you guys do a lot of country music. Have you thought of just busting into like I saw tigers, right? Like, and just watch the place erupt. I mean, wouldn't it erupt right now?
We do plan to when we go back out on the road to put that one of those songs in the set.
It's a piece of it.
You know, dude, think about it. You hit that at the right moment, right? Like, so you got the crowd and they're with you and you're like, what song should we do next? And you just feel it and you know it's your moment and you just start in and like, I saw tigers, and everybody's going to be like, right? Yes. Like,
what you only do.
It's placement.
Right. You only start off with that and then it goes dead silent. The lights all go down and then you hear dun. Dun, dun, dun. And then you guys launch into a country western version of Eye of the Tiger.
That's actually really nice. We might have to take that.
There's so many good ideas tonight, dude. Careers are going to get made from just this last hour. And probably
well,
ruined,
how can
too.
It not happen when we've got Kraken, the juice of good ideas?
Dave, I haven't seen you actually take any nectar from there.
Hit it, Dave.
I poured it straight into here and was drinking. What do I? You want
the cola? Let me see you take it from the tea.
Prove it. Yeah.
This is going downhill fast. Fill the Kraken, Dave.
Oh my!
Double. Oh God!
Oh! Wow! Does that count as double fisting? Since he had it with both hands.
Oh no! And that's when I take. Chip said no.
Oh, I'm sorry. That was my fault. I didn't mean to do that.
It's good timing.
Oh my God. Okay, listen.
Pulled all the moisture out of my head.
Wait, have you had Chip on the speakeasy?
Not yet, but like I think we'll get to everyone.
I don't know how many scarves he'll wear.
Oh my God, that's a great idea. He could do like a scarf every 2 minutes.
Nope, only scarves. I want him wrapped in every scarf he's ever worn on TV.
That's kind of hot.
You can let people place bets ahead of time. How many?
Wow. Yeah. No, this is good. Okay, listen, we're getting near the end here. So like we got to get a couple of plugs in. So okay. Jay and Rosanna, I think it's time to reveal the name. Now listen, Dave, have you heard the song? I heard the song.
I did.
I liked it.
I don't like to brag, but Jay said I was the second one that he sent it to. Well, at least that's what he told everybody.
It actually was true. You were the second
right after I got it.
Oh, yeah. It's not fair. We have to send it to Erin now because it's not fair. Please. I didn't have your contact.
Thank you. I can't wait.
It's only fair. So Erin's worth better than messy thirds, you guys. Come on.
I'm so sorry.
No, it's okay. But no, it's good. I can hear all your influences in the song for sure. Like it's really great stuff. And, you know, it's hard to talk about a song. You just got to hear it, but people will hear it on May the 4th. And are we ready? Are we ready to find out the name?
Yes. Let's do it.
Boom.
That's it.
Oh, amazing.
The echoes.
That is the cover art and the name of the song.
Yay.
So, all right. May 4th.
Cinco de Echo.
Star Wars Day. It drops Star Wars Day.
Yeah, well, it drops the day after Star Wars.
Oh, Cinco de Mayo. I'm sorry.
Yeah, Cinco de Mayo.
Forgive me. Cinco de Echo. All right, that's good. So, how do we hear it? Do we go to your website? Do we go to Facebook?
We go to his mom's basement in the bathroom.
We're gonna do a one. We're gonna do a one We're going to do a one live stream of it the day it comes out. The day it comes out, is that what it is, or the night before?
I think pre-orders, because it's going to be on yes. iTunes.
Everywhere.
Starting pre-orders start the 30th.
Pre-orders start the 30th of April, and it will be on pre-order until May 5th, and then it goes. Then everybody gets it on May 5th. At that
yeah,
point.
Yeah,
so.
Get it. And then we're doing a lyric video for it. And yeah, the day before on the 4th, we're gonna do just like we're gonna do an acoustic version of it.
For
yeah.
fun.
And then we're dropping it on
well, Wednesday. I for one can't wait to celebrate Cinco de Pinco when you guys drop it in the shower.
Yes.
Oh, that's a good one. That's it. Here we go.
Let's Ryder, what do you get coming up?
Cinco de Pinco.
I follow Ryder on Instagram and Twitter.
It's the first thing I've got coming up.
That's going down.
Mm-hmm. I'd like to thank George Cooney for that one.
Yeah. Mr. Cooney can make the hell out of some tequila, can he?
You're welcome, Erin Ryder.
That was George Cooney.
That was George Cooney, yeah.
Sending in a message of love.
I thought that was the Kraken. That was really scary.
Incredible.
No, this is the Kraken.
What the hell is that?
Well,
just go ahead and take the call. I don't care. Who is it? Put it on speaker.
It was
something about Obi-Wan is our last hope, I think, if I can understand the translation properly.
Right.
Incredible Chewbacca.
Yeah. No, good stuff. Schrader, what do you got coming up? Plug something. True Crime Tuesday. Ugh.
This
Saturday, on the show, we've got Jack and Katrina from Portals to Hell are going to be on Darkness Radio. Sunday, we have Dakota and Chelsea Layden from Destination Fear on the show. And you can find all that at darknessradio.com or check out our YouTube channel and keep
There's
up.
There's my mom. Show. There's my mom waiting to come on the show.
Nancy! Oh, my God, Nancy, I've been dying for you to come on. Next Friday, you're on.
Yeah. We should just have all our moms on.
Oh, my God, Gail's dying, too.
And Gail, we'll watch.
And then Ed McMahon, what's your name?
Yeah, Ed McMahon. Oh, my God, that would be the mom show.
Dave, what's your mom's name?
Great.
She plays the harp right now, unfortunately.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry, love.
Yeah, you went there, Erin. You brought it down at the end.
Nice.
I'm going to flip this table really quick, just in honor.
Oh, there's another freeze frame. Knock it off.
Here you go, Dave.
Oh, so you don't cry right in it. Oh, here we go.
All right. Yeah, Slamabama, give us one more song, and then we'll come back and say our goodbyes and ride this thing into the sunset. You guys ready?
Yes.
We're ready.
All right. Hit it.
Let's do it.
Well, I guess it would be nice if I could touch your body. Oh, no, not everybody. Somebody like you. I better think twice before I give them the heart away. Oh, I know all the games you play, cause I play them too. Oh, but I need some time off from that emotion. Time to get my heart up on the floor. Oh, when the love comes down without emotion. Oh, it takes a strong man, baby, but I'm taking to the door. Cause I gotta have faith. I gotta have faith. Well, I gotta have faith, faith, faith. I gotta have faith, faith, faith. Baby, I know you're asking me to stay. Say please, please, please don't go away. Say I'm giving you the blues. Baby, you knew every word to say. I can't help but think of yesterday. I never loved you, tie me down. We love a book before this river becomes an ocean. Oh, you pull my heart back on the road. Oh, but I
yay! And we lost Ryder.
No, I'm so sorry.
Oh, she never misses a song.
Oh,
Yay! Thank you all. This was fun.
Thanks. It was fun. Thanks for asking us. Thanks for inviting us. We appreciate it.
Yeah.
Remember when Dave said he didn't have any more props?
He lies.
No.
This isn't a prop. This is a way of life.
He's the hero we needed. He's the hero we deserve.
I can tell you this. Crime is down 100% in my block.
Oh, you know what you need to do is clean your apartment, though. Clean your.
It's time. Listen, everybody, stay safe. Thank you all for watching. Thanks for playing with us. Thanks for having a couple of drinks. We really appreciate it. Thank you.
And Slamabama for being amazing.
Thank you for being in your bathroom.
Thank you, Dave and Batman, whoever you are, wherever you are. Hey, I'm going to keep doing these. Be sure to follow me on Facebook and Instagram and all that stuff. There it's below Erin and Dave. Oh, look at that. There it is. And of course, if you want to tip your bartender, you can. There's the Venmo. If you're into that, we can tip. And be sure to check out all of our good friends here tonight. And this is like the Brady's now, where we say, bye, Erin. And
goodbye.
Bye, Dave.
And if you'd like to order colored pages. For $1.99 a page, email me.
I'm going to Venmo you right now.
This is going to be great. All right.
Love you, Slamabama. Cheers. Thank you.
Bye, you guys. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye-bye.